adorable kitten. What you doing? What you doing? You think you would have brought you some snacks of tuna? Just see if you want some tuna. I know you like tuna.
Thank you.
Tuna. I really like tuna. You're okay. It's okay. Good girl. Good girl. Such a good girl.
I'm not sure how I have her. I don't think I have her wrapped very well, so. I don't know where the edge is. There's her head. It's a very adorable head. Let's see. Let's see. Good girl. Good girl. Right. Yep, that's her head. Okay. Good girl. I'm gonna try not to have completely asleep legs this time. Okay. That is the head, I think. I think that's the head. I'm pretty sure. I'm trying to turn you this way. It will be very cozy for you once we get situated. There we go. Okay, you're a good girl. You've had lots of good contact time in the last couple of days. You're very brave. Very brave. There's a little snout. It's very cute. You're okay. I'm just gonna cover the little snout until we get a little bit more relaxed. There we go. You're a good girl. Are you a good girl? Feel good on your ear? Oh, she's such a good girl. She's very brave. She's trying to hide. I know the aliens did weird things to you yesterday, huh? But you survived. You think you survived sticking a knife to your ear? Should we start with some ear time? Maybe kind of carrot. I haven't seen her do any playing, but she didn't do any playing at the feeding station either. Let's see if she has a little catnip. If she relaxes at all. Or if she gets rambunctious. Or just ignores it. How are your ears feeling? A little gunky. Not too bad though. Doesn't look like it. Let's see if we can get a better look at it. Whoops. Such a brave, beautiful girl. Oh, there we go. Now I can see. Looking much better in there. Hers were definitely not the worst that we've seen. But they weren't the greatest either. You're such a good girl. Such a good girl. What a good girl. Are you gonna relax for me one of these days? You did pretty well at the beginning. Yes, you did. Would it be nice if you didn't give your babies your wife? I think we'll be here long enough to give you your second treatment before you have babies. That would be nice. That would be nice, huh? Are you still convinced that I'm gonna eat you? Yes. I haven't yet though. What happens if we show? Oh, does that make you want to run away? How about we do a little bit of hiding? You can hide a little bit. Yes. Can we clean this one? While we're here, may as well, huh? Then maybe we can try some tuna if you want some. This is kind of an awkward angle, isn't it? Oh. It's kind of an awkward angle. You're looking good though. Or at least better than before. Good girl. Such a good girl. You're very good. That was a very thorough cleaning that I did. It was vigorous. Now we're gonna try something that I think you will like if you don't run away first. Something that my cats will like because I will smell like tuna no matter what when I go home. Thick. It's pretty good. Oh, I should turn this off now. That wasn't so bad, huh? There's a big chunk. Do you want some tuna? No, there's nothing up here to look at. No need to worry. It's a good girl. Oh no, that's not gonna help. That's not gonna help people walking by. It's okay. It's alright. It's alright. It'd be nice if we could put a soundproof bubble over the HQ. Wouldn't that be nice? Then you would never have to be nervous about other people. You could just be nervous about me. We're not ready for tuna time yet. Not ready. Oh, little Miss Neelix. You are very cute. Very cute. So, Neelix is not, so she's more like Shiloh, I've been saying, in that she, it's great that she is able to be handled, but so far, she has like sort of relaxed enough to enjoy it a couple of very brief times, but she's quite easily spooked by any little noise or anything. Smells really good. And she's not like enjoying the petting enough to, I think, to overcome her fear of being eaten. So I think normally we've seen, if we're gonna see progress, like socialization potential, I think we see it within the first couple of days with all the other ones. Like we've had, you know, they've been really leaning into our hand or purring or what have you within the first couple of days. And we have not had that moment just yet. Although she certainly has a couple of times relaxed to some degree, but I think as she gets more confident, she is also more reluctant to tolerate time with the human, which is fine. It's fine. I just, you know, it would be super nice if you could, like, if you enjoyed a little bit of petting. It would be super nice for all of us. But it may not be. It may not be something that you're capable of, and that's totally fine, right? I know, this is such a weird situation. So weird. You're very cute. Let's try some tuna juice. The old tuna juice trick. Oh, see, it's pretty good. I know you like it. Try some. Try some, it's so good. She just thinks I'm trying to... Oh, there she goes. There she goes, a little bit. But... It's not so bad, huh? She is eating very well. Eating, drinking, going to the bathroom. Oh, using the litter box like a champ. She's very good. She's just not sure about this whole human thing. That's okay. I think that it's worth trying. See if I can get her a little more comfortable, but oh, are you gonna eat some tuna now? You think you might need some? I know you like tuna. You should eat it. So tasty. How are our babies doing? Are they good? That is a wound on her nose that she had when she came in. What are you thinking about leaving? So, genetically speaking, I believe that she could have Torby babies if Dad is Ginger. Because her base color is black. So I think we could possibly see Torby babies. Because girls get one color from mom and one from dad, so the girl would have to get the black color from mom and then the ginger from dad. She did quite well with the ultrasound yesterday. She was out eating in the cabinet within not very long of us leaving. She's been pretty relaxed, getting some nice deep sleep since then. Even though it's been noisy today. It's been noisy.